This is DH Radio on CJMQ 88.9 FM. Guys, how many jobs have you had? Well, if you're a part of Generation X or Y, or depending on your theories about who is called what, if you're in your 30s, chances are you've had several. And if you're in your 20s, chances are you'll probably have even more than we did. But can you imagine having 100 jobs? Not all at once, mind you, but can you imagine embarking on 100 different adventures employment-wise? Well, Amy Davison did just that. In fact, she's just in the midst of booking jobs 99 and 100. Amy, how are you doing?
I'm amazing. How are you?
I'm amazing too. I just want to be amazing.
Yeah, that sounded a little egotistical. I'm doing amazingly well, thank you. There you go. What?
We just should. All right, now tell me how you got started on this. First of all, where are you located?
I'm in Montreal, Quebec.
All right. And how did you come across this idea or decide to embark on the idea of 100 jobs? Explain it to me and our audience here.
Well, the genesis of the idea was because I was actually unemployed as an actor and a model, and I had previously produced a web series called Fashion Ambush, which got pitched to television, and then I was looking for a sponsor, and I brought on a co-producer, and it didn't work out. So I knew that web projects work really well online, and I was sort of inspired by the guy who traded up from a red paperclip to a house, or the guy who danced around the world, right? Mm. And I thought, okay, I'm going to start my own low-budget blogging and video logging project, and I'm going to prove that anyone can do this, and I'll just announce that I'm going to do 100 jobs for a minimum of $100 each and see where it goes. And it's worked out marvelously.
That's just amazing. All right, so what was job one?
Job one basically happened within 2 hours of my first posting on Craigslist, because how I got jobs at first was that I would put a call out for employers on different online classified services like Kijiji and Craigslist. So if it was with Brent Barrett of Social Media Montreal. Mm-hmm. I think now he's doing a venture capital web series, but he wanted me to come over and help him interview this man called Peter Schleicher of Athletes International. So I came over to his house, I held the camera, I also went in front of the camera, and it was over within 4 hours, and he paid me $100. Yeah.
It's remarkable that it all came together that quickly, you know? Like, I mean, I guess the whole concept of it is really catchy, so that part of it isn't hard to explain, but wow, that's okay. So, now, when did you start?
I started on September the 12th, 2009, and if I can give anyone a bit of advice about launching internet projects, you need a really good one-line pitch, because it was very easy for me to communicate immediately with potential employers what my project was about. I'm doing 100 jobs. It's not complicated, it's direct, and it's effective. So I think that's why it really just caught on. And also, too, the hallmark of a good idea is that you'll get a really interesting response or a large response right away. So 2 hours within a posting is pretty phenomenal and was a good indication that my project was going to work.
Wow. Yeah, I think I get completely what you mean. If it's too clunky or too many words or whatever, then people will start to lose focus really quickly. Whereas having something that's that crisp, 100 jobs, you know, and away you go. So, all right. So now you're coming up to jobs. You're booking jobs 99 and 100. Has that happened?
It has not happened. Job 99, I'm in discussions with a company for job 99, which is going at $5,000. So I'm likely going to produce a video or a little social media marketing campaign or some sort of guerrilla marketing stunt for them. And job 100 is really interesting, because what happened was, because this project has proved so successful for me, and I've booked actually a lot of jobs that I haven't even reported on, I had a good couple of months, and I bought art by James Franco.
Yeah.
James Franco, the American actor, launched, I know, it seems preposterous, but he launched his own Kickstarter project, and I immediately saw it as an ideal marketing opportunity via social media, and plus it's cool to sponsor other artists, but I saw it as a really bold American PR move, and it totally paid off. So Praxis, seeing as I paid $10,000 for or towards their project, they've now hired me for potentially Job 100 to find them a $100,000 sponsor. Mm-hmm. And the sponsor gets, the naming rights to the museum. They get their name plastered all over the website and a really aggressive PR campaign, because James Franco's pretty hot in the gossip media right now.
Oh, yeah.
And that's really what drives the web. That's what drives social media.
James Franco's hot in several ways. And that's, you know, trapped between boulders with one arm. And I was like, wow, he's still cute. You know? So explain, what's the, it's the Museum of Non-Visible, no, how does this, what's the title of the museum again? What is it called right now?
The Museum of Non-Visible Art, or the acronym is MONAF for short.
So what the heck is non-visible art? It's just that it's, that I find really, that's a fascinating kind of concept. What's the deal behind non-visible art?
Well, it's conceptual art. So it's art that is imagined. First, it's described via the written word. So when I bought the piece, Fresh Air, for $10,000, I'm actually buying a description card that's going to go on a plaque that I get to keep. So they basically don't have physical works of art aside from the plaques. They just have descriptions. One was inspired by Red Leaves, a poem. Others are more out there, like Giant Hairball. And they're all... I know. And they all come at different price points. But the thing is, it's not just a conceptual art project. It's going to be performed. So it's basically a conceptual art performance piece. They're going to actually tour this invisible, or rather non-visible, because it's not invisible, it still exists, museum across Europe and North America, and perform it. So every time they say, okay, here's Fresh Air, imagine yourself on an amazing vista looking up into the sky with, you know, the sun shining in your face. This was purchased by Mae Davison, who is now owning this, the freshest part of the museum. So that, wow, too, is kind of really, yeah.
That's
awesome.
So not only did you have this opportunity to buy non-visible art by James Franco, but you also, your name is now a part of this tour. It's a part of this museum.
And it's a part of popular culture. I think I really enjoy getting intimately involved with the mythology of new media and popular culture.
Wow. Oh my goodness. What you're doing is huge. Tell me, okay, now let's go back to 100 jobs. And now that we've had an idea of what the end result is going to be, I'm doing the ghosts of Ebenezer Scrooge's ghosts of Christmas past, present, and future all mixed up. Apparently they come in the wrong order this time. So let's look at the kind of the mid ground. We talked about job one. We talked about jobs 99 and 100. In the middle, what are the ones in this adventure, this almost 2 years of your life, would you say are the things that have stood out the most?
Honestly, the jobs that have been the most emotional are the ones that have been the most enjoyable. I recently did a spray painted street art mural.
I watched that.
Yes. It's cute. Isn't it cute?
Yes. It was a beautiful case. Okay, so go on. I cut you off there. I just had to interject because I watched it with rapt attention. So, yeah. Explain to the listeners what it was that you did. What number was that?
That was... Hold on. Let me look. I actually have my resume. You know, I have to...
During the day, I am a job search specialist. So it's really interesting that now you have this. I was just imagining the curriculum vitae of a person who's done 100 jobs and me kind of going, oh boy, okay, I have to do a job search for this person. This is going to be interesting.
Yeah, well, you can actually, or anyone can view my resume if you click on jobs on 100jobs.ca or .com, doesn't matter which you go to. There's actually a tab that says jobs, and I update my resume with not only the jobs I've done, but it's linked to the pages describing my experience of having completed the job. Basically a young husband had hired me to make street art as a wedding present for his wife. He originally had posted on Craigslist, and actually he had said he was looking, he didn't disclose how much he was paying, but I pitched myself to him because, again, sometimes I'll apply for jobs and then talk them up to whatever amount I think is appropriate.
Yep.
And last minute, basically 2 days before his wedding, he said, listen, I had booked another spray paint artist that fell through. Would you be willing to do it for, and I shouldn't tell you, like, X amount, because, I don't want to tell his wife how much he paid for the wedding present. And I have a background in art. I've painted my entire life. So I knew how to make a really good stencil, and he wanted a mural of a Canada goose and a chickadee flying underneath. So I imagine he's the Canada goose and she's the chickadee.
Oh.
Yeah, with their wedding date. And so I did that, and I found a location that I didn't think I was really damaging public property. And I spray painted it on a plexiglass covering on a bridge somewhere in Montreal. And they loved it.
It really is. It's really a beautiful story. I'm going to have to post the YouTube video so that people can go and check it out and actually watch you do the whole thing. And it was moving to me to see you moved at the end of it. That sold me that much more on interviewing you. I was already excited to do so, but watching you be so present in that experience was like, that's pretty touching. That's pretty amazing.
Well, I think that's why my project has been successful, because I am always intimately involved with every single one of my jobs. I give my 100%. I am not a slacker. And I think that is a large part of this project's success. You know, at certain points, I was even working 12 hours a day on this between, you know, applying for jobs and building my Twitter account and just getting my name out there. And that hard work has paid dividends. But without that passion, you know, none of this would have happened.
Now, on the other end of the spectrum, relationships-wise, you did eHarmony.com parodies for MakeYourGirlfriendHappy.com.
Yes. Like
this. So your task mostly is laughing at men mostly, is what is described as the description for that one. I just love it. There's so many impersonating in French, Guillaume Sans Façon on Facebook for 5 days.
Yeah, that was really interesting. It was actually a student at the Université de Montréal, I think, at UQAM? No, yes, that's right, Université de Québec à Montréal. So there's a student at UQAM who had an art project, and he had to do, I believe, a public performance piece. So he found out about me because I believe I had lectured at the University of Montreal after I had done Yellow Page Mountain, which is a whole thing, you know, a whole other thing entirely.
Mm-hmm.
And he just wanted to see if his friends would even notice on a social network if he wasn't himself.
So that's great. Oh, and
yeah.
You did, and you, now Lady Jane's job 67, clothing stylist for Lady Jane's Treasure Trove. Lady Jane has been on DH Radio as well. Talking
Wonderful.
About the treasure trove. There's just so many great things that you have been involved in. Everybody's going to have to go to 100jobs.ca.com and click on jobs and just take a look at this amazing list of wonderful things. It makes me want, you know, it's funny, I've probably had 17 jobs if I really was to count them all up, and enjoyed everything that I've ever done. And I think that's it. That's part of the reality of this generation, is just that things will change, and there are things called contracts, you know, which didn't exist so much in our parents' time. And so just the idea of being able to go through this is wonderful. And now,
well, thank you.
Now, you've pronounced your first name Aimé.
Yes.
Which
yes.
I mispronounced it at the beginning, which is great. And I think that I had done that mostly because of your last name. I went with an anglicized version of your first name. This is so exciting. What the heck is next? What are you going to do? How are you feeling about the idea that you're, after 2 years, you're like getting close to the end of this experience?
Well, I'm excited, and I've already started in a way to transition. I'm finishing writing my book, because I'm going to turn my experience into an ebook that anyone who wants to improve their career or any actor and model who wants to promote themselves online can use. I also launched kind of a funny, sexy fail blog on Tumblr called lolpervs.com. So it's totally different. It's more gong show. My name's Daisy Dukes. I'm kind of a bit like the YouTube star Ray William Johnson, in that I review, you know, the craziest, sexy videos on YouTube.
I love it.
Yeah, and I already have ad revenue for one of the videos, so it's working quite well. And I have plans to turn 100 Jobs into the name of my social media and internet production company.
Mm-hmm.
Originally, I was going to go under the name of Aimé Davidson Productions, but because 100 Jobs is so memorable and I've built up my Twitter following quite significantly, I don't want to let go of it. I really enjoy it. And one final idea I had, whimsical idea, is that I somehow would get a sponsor who would allow me to do 100 jobs around the world. And I think that could be really beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, my goodness, like, you just have to keep living with this kind of fervor, because this is, it's clearly something that is, that it has grown into its own kind of force, and it has picked up this precious momentum. Like, wow.
Yeah, it took a while. But it's good when anybody launches their own blog or their own internet project. They need to know it's a marathon, not a sprint. It doesn't happen right away. Like, at the beginning, you'll get a large reaction, but it kind of, you know, it's a bit of a roller coaster, and you just have to ride it through and have faith that if you're being authentic, if you're pursuing your passion, if you're focused and you're hardworking, it will work out.
Now, that is I think that's the note that we have to end on. Guys, you have to just go to 100jobs.ca or .com and check out what Aimée Davidson doing. This is, like, you're wonderful. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you. So are you.